All right, guys, I'm back, and we're joined by none other than the legendary WWE Hall of Famer, Mr. Jimmy Snuka. Jimmy, how are you doing?
Lovely, brother. Thank you very much for having me.
Oh, thank you for joining us. We also have our co-hosts, Demetrius and Shane, on the line. Guys, are you there?
Glad to have you with us, Mr. Snuka.
Thank you very much there, brother.
Our second co-host, he's taking care of his kids. He had to drop him off real quick, but he'll be joining us momentarily. But, you know, we've been talking a lot about legacies and legends of the business. You just had your WrestleMania appearance not too long ago. It wasn't your first WrestleMania. You were there in WrestleMania number one, the first one. How did it feel to be in the 25th anniversary of WrestleMania?
Well, brother, to be honest with you, I just broke the record again.
What was the record you broke?
Well, I guess I was the oldest guy that ever wrestled in WrestleMania 25, brother.
That's right, that's right. And how did you feel in the ring? Were you feeling good? How did people receive you?
You know what, brother? I feel great, like a 65-year-old man. And brother, it was so awesome. It's so hard to explain it, brother, because I mean that's WrestleMania 25, brother, and I was really proud to be involved in it. You know.
Right. And you go way back. You've, people remember all the your rivalries, and even you've had Mick Foley, who saw you jump off the cage onto Don Morocco. What's it like to having people of your in the business who look up to you? What's that like?
You know what, brother? It's a really appreciation, you know. To myself, the way I always think is if you're good to the Lord and you're down here, you got to take care of your missionary work, brother, and do the right thing and get in there and have fun and, concentrate and stay focused on what you're doing. And, that's how these kids get involved, because when you do something right, brother, they love it. And I love it when they love it.
Yeah, definitely, definitely. Go ahead, Jay.
Yeah, you were talking about the kids getting into the business. Could you give us like a brief summary of how you yourself got into the world of professional wrestling?
All right. Actually, I was in Hawaii. I was training at a gym called Powerhouse. And former Mr. Hawaiian Island, his name was Dean Noguchi, and he started his gym there in Waikiki, which is, that place will really cheer you up quick. But anyway, I was training in the gym, and all the professional wrestlers there, brother, used to come and, work out at our gym and everything. And since we had a former Mr. Hawaiian Islands, and he's a professional wrestler, and so all the guys that come from the mainland on their way to Japan, they stop in Hawaii for like 2 or 3 weeks, all depends, and they go to Japan, they come back to Hawaii and wrestle again for a couple of weeks, and go back to the mainland. So I was pretty lucky because every time they rotated professional wrestlers, I get to meet them all in the gym. And, they turn around and told me, says, hey, brother, I know you're training for Mr. Hawaiian Island contest, but, why don't you forget about that and let's go make some money, you know?
Right.
I said, you know what, brother, if I don't accomplish what I worked hard for, I ain't gonna get it until I get it first. And then we can get into the business, you know?
Right.
And so, at the meantime, I grew up watching all these guys in Hawaii back and forth. And I finally made up my mind that I was going to finish, you know, I gotta win this Mr. Hawaiian Island contest. And as soon as I won that, you know, I won it in 1970. And right from there, it all started. I started to train and, you know, then I was on my way to Portland, Oregon is where I first started off my professional wrestling.
Okay. Now you said you were a fan growing up. You got into the business. You went to Portland, Oregon to get your start. At what point did you say, man, I'm good at this. I am a good and potentially great professional wrestler?
Well, you know what, brother? I didn't want to go overboard, you know. I didn't want to miss climb over one step. I always go one step at a time, brother, and, you know, make sure that, you know, I'm doing the right thing. So when I finally got into the ring and wrestled all these professional wrestlers, and especially the old school guys, you know, I was very lucky that when I came into it, you know, back in them days, you know, they were serious, and, you know, you got to be serious about everything, and I was very lucky, and, you know, I've been very blessed with the Lord, and, you know, to wrestle with all these great old-timers, and they taught me, brother, and, you know, they always say, don't get excited, just go in there and have fun, you know?
Right,
and
definitely.
What they do, they relax you, and you go in and you wrestle, you know, and, you know, don't think about, you know, that's what you train for, is to do what you go inside to the ring. When you go into the ring first time, brother, you got to memorize your whole homework, because this whole wrestling, you know, wrestling is a different college, you know?
Right.
And you have to memorize everything and know everything and know how it's going to go about, and you better be ready for it, brother.
Now, you spoke on getting in the ring with, you know, various legends. Who was your favorite all time to square off against?
This one guy is a local boy from Hawaii. They call, you know, he's a wrestler, you know, and he used to come to the gym all the time, you know, and he's a local Hawaiian boy, and he was the one that, you know, really got me going and everything, and ever since I watch him wrestle, you know, I just love it, brother.
Okay, definitely, definitely. Now, there's been a lot of mainstream of attention on wrestling lately, a lot of it due to the wrestler. I saw somewhere online that it was loosely based on your life. Is that true to your knowledge or false? Do you know?
Well, but like I said, I always got to be straight about everything, bro. You know, and that's the way I like to be. And I'm always like a competition to myself, you know, to know that I'm involved in a situation like this. And, you know, I better take care of it, you know. And you take care of business, you take care of yourself, and everything will be just coming down the road. And I look forward to that.
Right, right. Now, did you see The Wrestler? Did you sit down and watch it?
Oh, yeah. You bet. Well, I watch it every time, brother.
Did you like it? So you liked it? Was it an accurate depiction of what wrestlers go through, especially those who've been out of the limelight?
Yeah, you know, brother, you know, I know I watch it if I'm not wrestling or anything like that, you know, and I mean, it's a great feeling to watch all these kids, you know, try to get in there and wrestle and, you know, try to focus on things, you know, and, but you gotta be really mental, you know, involved in yourself and, you know, take care of your responsibility and, you know, you gotta, well, have everything completed before you're ready to do something, you know?
Definitely. And for those just tuning in, we're on the line with WWE Hall of Fame.